Alright, today's lesson is about the pneumatic system. As we know, pneumatics is using air to actually perform work. Usually it's compressed air, so what we normally have is we have a compressor. In this case, this is a pneumatic trainer that we have. It'll demonstrate a few of the functions of the pneumatic system. What you have is you have an air compressor that's in the back. It actually takes atmospheric pressure and compresses it to somewhere in the neighborhood of 50 to 100 psi. And then it actually uses different attributes or different devices to actually do work. When in work, we may be talking about an actuator such as an air motor, which uses rotational device, a cylinder, which actually uses linear motion. This is a single acting cylinder, and this is another double acting cylinder there. A few of the components of this trainer, you have the feed. This is where the air is fed from the air compressor. The air tank is, which is in the back as well, to a gauge. Off of here, you come off here, we have another regulator here. This is a push button directional control valve. This is a lever directional control valve. We have a check valve, some gauges, a lubricator if you wanted to add oil to the system for lubricating the joints. You have some flow control valves. These adjust the flow by allowing the cranks here. And then you have another directional control valve here, the air motor, a cylinder, a double acting cylinder, a single with a spring, and a double acting cylinder there. So, and then safety, of course, anytime that you're working around air pressure, you want to make sure that you utilize the proper PPEs. Make sure you don't spray the actual air onto a human to clean off the body or your clothes, one, because of the pressure that's involved, and two, because of the actual oil that's involved in there. All right, the first thing that we're gonna set up will be we're gonna look at the single acting cylinder. This is the one right here. We're gonna run it through a directional control valve, a lever directional control valve, so that we can kind of see how it works doing the process. We connect it to the power source here. The power source, the air is off. We put it to the inside of the directional control valve here. Connect one here, and I'm not quite long enough, so let me see if I can find a longer hose. Here we go. And we'll connect it to the actual cylinder there, into the valve, and then we'll actually install another one here to act as a muffler or release of the air as the spring forces the air down. So we'll start by turning the air on. The air pressure is on. You can read we're sitting right about 30 psi, and you can check it out. There doesn't appear to be any leaks. We'll activate the lever, and what do we have? We have air coming out the other one. So what we need to do is we need to kind of push around the connectors and try it again, and you can see the gauge moving up. Release the air. The spring releases it back down, go back, the air goes back up, the cylinder goes back up, releases the air. Now, in order to add an extra wrinkle to this, we can connect this to a flow control valve. Flow control valve, as you remember, actually controls the flow of how much or how fast the actuator moves. So, install it, we turn it really down pretty low, we interact the lever, and watch how slow it moves up. I didn't do anything different. I pushed down on it. It's the valve control does the work for us. Crank that up a little bit more, and you can see a little bit faster. Apply a little bit more, a little more, and you can see it goes even faster. So, directional control valve creates the speed at which the cylinder moves up or down. Okay, that's a single acting cylinder. Now we're going to look at making sure that the system's pressure down before we start moving anything. Now we'll actually take it and we'll do the actual motor itself. We'll take our feed that was actually going over to the cylinder. We'll put it into the motor. And if you remember in this one here, what happens is when you activate it, the air will run through the vanes of the motor, spinning the shaft, which you can barely see right there, but you should be able to hear the actual air as it's escaping through the cylinder. So you push turn it back on, We repressurize the system. We turn the lever, and you can hear the air. The air is running through the motor. Any extra air is being discharged through the muffler, therefore spinning, using the vanes to actually spin the actual the motor so it could actually do work. Okay. Lastly, we're going to work on, we're actually going to show or demonstrate the use of the double acting cylinder. And so what we can do is we can connect one to one side. Connect another to the other side, and should be able to see, turn the pressure back on, should be able to see, goes down, goes up, goes down, depending on the, depending on which position that the directional control valve is in, depends on the work. Now what you can do to add a little wrinkle to that, you can add it through a flow control valve, such as this, and you can control, see how slow it's going down. The directional control valve is keeping the air from moving so fastly so that it slows down the actuator. Speed it up a little bit more. Actually, let's try that again. See how it's being controlled. It goes up fast because we don't have a directional control valve on that mechanism, but we do on it going down. See how slowly it's going to go? And what we'll do is we'll push it back up. We'll speed it up, and then you can see it goes a little faster, a little more fluid. Directional control valve. Up, back a little bit faster, so we can adjust it in motion, and there it goes. All right, so briefly, that is the pneumatic system. You can see that the air, which is run by an air compressor through a regulator, has a lot of possibilities when it comes to work. Air motors, double-acting cylinders, and then regular one-way cylinders. That concludes today's presentation on the pneumatic system. The PowerPoint slides are available, and at the end, you'll be able to take your exam. Thank you.